For the new president and CEO of the Kentucky Chamber of Commerce that advocates for businesses large and small, Ashli Watts' accidental career, as she has called it, gave way to a rapid ascension to the helm of that agency. And coming up, we have a great, fun, fast-paced conversation with Ashli Watts, who is no stranger to KET, just on this side of the studio.
That's right. I've never been on this side.
You've never been on this side.
Yeah.
It's so good to see you.
Yes, thank you for having me.
Congrats to you, the youngest female chamber leader statewide.
Yes.
But statewide chamber.
Yes.
So I know you get tired of asking how significant that is to you, but how significant is that to you?
You know, it is. I said, obviously, you want to get this job on your merits and your hard work. But I do think we need to acknowledge that it's kind of a turning of a page and kind of a passing a torch to the next generation of workforce.
Yeah.
And, you know, I am a 37-year-old mother of two. And so it's kind of neat. I have a 7-year-old daughter to show her that there was never any question that her mother could maybe be the president of a statewide organization.
Right.
And so any kind of little chip at the glass ceiling that I can provide is pretty exciting.
Yeah. One of the things, and we didn't talk about this during the interview, that folks will see, but I am curious because you are representing businesses statewide, mm-hmm. large and small, mm-hmm. rural and urban.
Right.
I mean, that's a pretty good balancing act with mm-hmm. interest when you think about such things as sports betting
right.
and other things that there can be, as we talk about in the show, a more evident rural and urban mm-hmm. divide. How
yeah.
does the chamber kind of navigate those interests?
That's a great question. I've been talking a lot about that lately to really make sure that people realize how methodical our process is. When we come out for an issue, it's not just myself in a room with my lobbyist figuring out what we like and what we don't like. Everything we do is membership driven. So the majority of our members, almost, I think 80%, are small businesses. That's really kind of the heart of the chamber. And so we make sure they are part of the process. So we have multiple policy councils where every single member of the chamber, no matter what level you are invited and really encouraged to participate. And we are brought issues by legislators, the administration, members, and those issues are literally vetted. Mm-hmm. They are, you know, someone from the pro side, someone from the con side. There's debate, discussion, research, and then those councils literally do an up and down vote.
Mm-hmm.
And then that recommendation goes to our board of directors to make sure that they agree with it and then goes on our agenda. We also do every summer a survey of all of our membership on all of these issues to make sure our finger is really on the pulse. And so every single member gets that. You know, we don't usually get unanimous decisions.
Sure.
There usually is some kind of divide, but usually it's a pretty clear-cut distinction. I mean, it's a large majority that are in one way or the other. So there really are several checks to make sure that we're really representing the entire business community from East, South, the Northwest, large to small business, and everything in between. And it's a tight balancing act, but we do a pretty good job by really making sure everything we do comes from our membership.
Right. And not just, like you said, kind of self-propelled, because
right.
maybe it's you might have a different opinion about it.
Right.
But your membership
yeah.
is spoken. Well, you'll get to learn more about the Kentucky Chamber and Ashli Watts coming up on Connection Sunday at 12 noon on KET, the main channel. It repeats again on KET 2 at 6 p.m. You can watch anytime online after that at KET.org/connections. Hope you'll join us.